Hello everyone. We have learnt about the concept of inclusive education in my previous video. As the picture shows, inclusion means everyone. The schools following inclusive education provide good quality education to all types of learners, those with and without disabilities. All these schools believe that all children can learn under the same roof. Thus, teachers in inclusive schools should possess certain qualities to be able to cater to diverse needs of their students. So, through this video, we will look into some of the qualities of an inclusive teacher. Dr. Umesh Sharma, a reputed international inclusive educationist of Monash University, says that teachers need to make changes in their three H's to become inclusive teachers. Sounds interesting, doesn't it? Well, these three H's represent the three domains given by Dr. Benjamin Bloom. These domains are, first, the cognitive domain, that is the head, which deals with our knowledge. The second is the affective domain, that is our heart, which determines our feelings, our emotions, our attitude. And the third one is the psychomotor domain, that deals with our skills, how skillful we are. And that's why it is denoted by the hand. So let's try and categorize the qualities of an inclusive teacher using these three H's. We begin with the head or cognitive domain. An inclusive teacher knows about the concept of inclusive education. That is, all children can learn, and that each one of them can be given good quality education. There are various principles governing inclusive education, which the teacher needs to know to follow successful inclusive practices. The government has drafted some policies and acts regarding inclusive education, which the inclusive teacher should know, as it helps them become aware of the rights of the students with disabilities and also the facilities that are available for inclusion. The inclusive teacher should also know the classification of students with disabilities. These students could be physically, mentally, emotionally, or socially challenged. For example, there are also different types of learning difficulties like dyslexia, dysgraphia, or dyscalculia. The teacher should be able to identify the challenges faced by the student. At the same time, the teacher does not forget the strengths or abilities of the student. It does not mean that the teacher focuses on only what the students cannot do. The teacher should also know what the students can do. This knowledge is required especially while planning for individual education program for these students. The other important thing is that the inclusive teacher needs to know the behavioral indications of students with disabilities or the differently abled students. For example, it's not easy to identify the slow learners. Hence, the knowledge about these indications should be known, and it becomes very vital so that the teacher is able to identify the challenge. There are specific instructional strategies to cater to the needs of diverse learners. The inclusive teacher must know these instructional strategies like co-teaching or team teaching, circle of friends, remedial teaching, blended learning, etc. These strategies have specific steps for their proper implementation in the classroom. The inclusive teacher not only knows about these strategies, the procedure of these strategies, but also knows when to use them. To cater to diverse learners, the inclusive teacher knows about different learning resources, which are teaching aids or assistive technologies that are available for different learners. These learning resources could be traditional ones like chart or flashcards or even the blackboard, and even digital in nature, like various software applications that are available. So learning resources, knowing about them becomes very important. Finally, the inclusive teacher must know about the different types of evaluation tools and techniques that can be used to appropriately evaluate different learners. Now, these are the qualities of an inclusive teacher, which is related to the head or the cognitive domain. Moving on to the next domain, the affective domain. Now, this affective domain is related with the heart. This domain is very important as it determines one's attitude. It is imperative that an inclusive teacher should have a positive attitude towards inclusive education. The inclusive teacher is sensitive to the needs of the differently abled students and takes care that no child feels neglected during classroom interaction and learning, and also that every child experiences a sense of belongingness. These teachers are confident during the interaction with the differently abled students. Such kind of interaction reduces nervousness and anxiety amongst the students and helps in increasing the rapport between teachers and students, both with and without disabilities. Being empathetic is one of the most essential qualities of an inclusive teacher. The inclusive teacher should not have sympathy for the students with disabilities, as sympathy denotes that the sympathizer is superior. However, the empathetic teacher will be able to understand the feelings of the student as if it were their own feelings, and thereby understand the needs of the students. The inclusive teacher follows reflective practices, as they need to use a variety of teaching strategies, teaching resources, and evaluation techniques and strategies. Thus, the teacher needs to introspect and reflect on the practices that were useful in the class and those which need modifications. Journals are very useful to keep such records. This is essential to make inclusion successful in the class. Peers in the classroom usually tend to avoid students with disabilities. However, a cheerful teacher will always help reduce the anxiety among students with disabilities. This is imitated by other students who are typically developed. Eventually, the classroom becomes a comfortable environment for all students to interact and learn. Finally, patience. This is one quality which is very important for an inclusive teacher. The teacher has to use a variety of ways to build up trust and communication with diverse learners. This may take a very long time to build. For example, if the teacher is dealing with a child having autistic syndrome. Sometimes it takes a long time to identify the appropriate ways to teach differently abled students. At times, the teacher may need to repeat or try out new methods many times until it is fruitful. This demands loads of patience and perseverance. So these are the qualities that are related to the affective domain. Moving on to the psychomotor domain. The psychomotor domain deals with skills and hence is denoted with the hand. These qualities determine how skillfully the inclusive teacher is able to implement inclusion. The inclusive teacher is a keen observer and is able to identify the needs of diverse learners and implement inclusive practices. This inclusive quality is very important because this observation skill is also helpful in keeping track of students' performances, both for students with and without disabilities. The inclusive teacher deals with diverse learners in a common classroom. Hence, the teacher is skillful in developing teaching aids and resources that cater to the needs of these learners. For example, if there is a hearing impaired student in the classroom and the teacher wants to show a video clip, then the teacher has to include subtitles which can be read by the student. Worksheets too can be modified to cater to the needs of diverse learners. Hence, an inclusive teacher is skillful in developing and modifying resources. As we have seen earlier, inclusive education can be implemented by using different instructional strategies like team teaching or blended learning, etc. Thus, the inclusive teacher is ready for collaboration, which requires good communication skills. Often they need to collaborate with special teachers or sometimes even with peers who could be gifted students. Sometimes they need to collaborate with parents or even with counselors. This collaboration is required to help students with disabilities or differently abled students overcome various hurdles in learning. Teaching aids can be useful only if the teacher is able to handle them skillfully. This is true for all types of teachers. However, for inclusive teachers, it becomes more essential as they may have to use more than one teaching aid in order to cater to the needs of diverse learners. So, skillfully organizing and implementing different teaching aids becomes a very crucial part in an inclusive classroom. Just having knowledge about different teaching strategies is not enough. The inclusive teacher is able to select and implement the appropriate teaching strategy matching the needs of the learners. The same goes for evaluation strategies. Inclusive education is very flexible and hence a common test is not used to evaluate all learners. Students can be tested differently depending on their abilities. Hence, the inclusive teacher is skillful in selecting or developing and administering different evaluation tools and techniques as per the requirements of the learners. These are some of the characteristics of an inclusive teacher, which has been categorized into these three domains or the three H's. So, the inclusive teacher does not ask, how do I change these students? Instead, asks, how do I have to change in order to give full membership of these students and get active participation of all my learners? To summarize, the inclusive teacher has a knowledgeable head to know about the needs of different students, a large heart to accept differently abled students, and a skillful hand to handle all types of students. These are the references which you can use as additional reading material about the topic. I do hope you liked the video and appreciate the qualities that it takes to become an inclusive teacher. Thank you.